know, one of the greatest happenings in all of the world was when Jesus Christ was born in Bethlehem, a king born in a manger where the donkeys and the sheep and everybody was living. But there he was wrapped in swaddling clothes. At a later time, then the wise men came and they brought him gifts. And you know, I truly hope that you have brought your gift to the king. You say, Arlene, what could I possibly give the king? Your heart. That's what he wants. That's the greatest gift you could ever give the Lord, is yourself. And as we're celebrating this wonderful, wonderful season, season of miracles, the miraculous birth of Christ and how he got here, and the season when, you know what, when you allow your faith to go and to grow, it's amazing what God will do. I trust that we are keeping our focus on the reason for this season. That's not a cliche. That's the truth. What's the reason for the season? It's Jesus Christ, the one that will that came to change mankind forever, was born to die for you and for me. But we celebrate his birth now. That tiny baby wrapped in swaddling clothes. Oh, what joy, what joy. The angels were singing, glory to God in the highest and on earth, peace, goodwill to all men. Powerful, powerful message. And we still sing it today. We still sing it today. I pray that you are ready for your holiday. Pray that your family and friends have been invited. And today we're going to share our Christmas dinner with all of you. And we hope you get some good ideas to share with your family and friends for that very special day. Please keep the focus on Jesus. Please do that. But first, I have a very special message for you, and here it is. To prepare a Christmas dinner, you need friends and family to help. We got friends, we got family, and I hope you do, because Paul's here. He's going to make an appetizer, and you're going to chop up some vegetables, right?
Yes.
And you're going to get them ready right over there. So go ahead, you can get started.
Thank you.
All right, sweetie. And Laura's going to make some. It's what's it called? Loaded baked potato salad. Baked potato salad. All right. Sounds good. She's got a lot of stuff. Tell us what's in there.
Well, first, ahead of time, I did the red potatoes. I cleaned them, just cubed them, boiled them, made them tender, not too soft. So that can be done ahead of time, a day. It's nice.
Yeah, it has to be cold. They have to be cold.
Refrigerated.
Okay, just
and
tell
just
us what all these
have
are.
Sour cream, everything gets put into the bowl. You mix the ingredients. Sour cream, mayo, ranch dressing, green onions.
Ranch dressing, that's nice.
Yeah, it gives them nice flavor. And save a little bit of the chives for the end, the topping. Cheese, cheddar cheese, some bacon, that'll be nice and salty.
Oh, yeah.
A little vinegar and salt and pepper to taste.
Wow.
So you mix this.
That sounds great.
And that's
sounds
it. And
wonderful.
Then you put your potatoes in.
Okay.
So I'll go ahead and do
now,
that.
I want to show you what I've done here with a ham. This is a ham that we have been baking for a couple of hours. It's a Smithfield ham and it's pre-sliced. And as I do with all my hams, I put it in 325, and I pour cider vinegar over the ham. That takes the saltiness, and if there's any kind of a wild taste to it, neutralizes it. After that's done, in this, I've made my own topping. Now, you're gonna spoon half of this topping over this ham to cover. Doesn't matter if it goes down in the bottom, you're not gonna baste what's in the bottom. You don't wanna use that for that. So you just keep pouring this over the top. Wanna make sure it gets in every little nook and cranny, because that's what's gonna add such flavor. And let me tell you what's in here. There's a bottle of chili sauce. There's pineapple. There's cloves, whole cloves. You know, like we stuff in the little cracks. You just put them in here and let it boil with it. You get the essence of it, but you don't have to do all that work of stuffing those into the cracks, okay? Now you're gonna use about half of this. And keep spooning it. Spooning it. Doesn't that look awesome? Oh, and the smell here is incredible. Just incredible. You never want to baste with any of the drippings that have come down from that apple cider vinegar. You discard that, throw it away. Just gonna go back in for about 30 minutes. Lori, if you would do so, the honors. And while she does that, I'm gonna start to make something that's gonna go on our dinner table along with the potatoes and all the other stuff we're making. And this is called chicken cordon bleu casserole. First of all, move that away there. Get my dish up here where I can handle it. I mean, there's so much going on in this kitchen today, I feel like we need to be in bigger places. But we've got about 8 boneless, skinless chicken breasts, and we've just cut them up in pieces, okay? And this buttered casserole is 13x9. You don't want your chicken to be kind of on the dry side. Try to get the moisture all off of it. And you just spoon those into this dish, like so. You want to make that into a single layer. So important. You have your shopping done?
Oh, no, I didn't even start.
What?
Yeah, I didn't even
you're gonna
start.
You're going to be in trouble.
I know.
Okay,
last
Nino,
minute.
Alan, you're getting nothing for Christmas.
Minute.
Johnny, forget it. Mother will get the sales and she'll give it to you later. Wow, you got to get started.
I know.
Are you always last minute?
No, but this year has just been a little bit
different.
Huh?
Sure.
And I take it you're done.
Well, pretty much so
pretty
by
much.
This point, yeah. Now I have just some ham that I got at the deli, had them slice it, and we cut it in pieces. We're gonna cover this with ham. Be generous. We have a lot of ham to put on this. It's gonna be so good.
Does it matter what type of ham?
Well, I think you want a lean ham, and this is a good baked or boiled, because it's moister. You know, and when you bake them, you don't want them to dry out. So I kind of use a good quality ham. About 8 slices really is what you're supposed to use, but they want you to cut it up on the recipe that I saw. Cut it up so that when you go to serve it, you take a spoonful. You're not like with a big piece of ham hanging there. So that's not agreeable. And you need to preheat your oven to 350 degrees. And we have our ovens good and hot. You know, anything you can do ahead of time and bake it off and get it done, do it. It makes just that last minute when everybody's coming to the door and you're trying to get it on the table, just makes it so much easier, so much easier. So we pretty much have our ham placed all over the casserole. We go back. I usually go over it one time, making sure that every piece of chicken has some on it, and then I go back and add extra. So that's what I'm gonna do here. Now we have Swiss cheese. I like Swiss cheese. Even when I make my, doesn't seem like it's traditional, but when I make my chicken parmesan, I like the Swiss because it really strings nice. Very good. Okay, so we have more that. Now we're putting our cheese, and we're just gonna drop this all over here. Just everywhere. Little chunks. How are you doing, baby?
I'm pretty good.
Oh, good. He loves radishes, so he's doing the radishes. Figure that would, turn them on over there, big bag of radishes. And you've got your, oh, that potato salad looks wonderful.
Yeah.
And did you put salt and pepper in that too?
Salt, pepper, a little bit of vinegar, red wine vinegar, just a dab.
Uh-huh.
And then I saved the
bacon.
Yeah, I'm gonna put the bacon on the top.
Okay.
I mean, it'll look, and you know, it'll look pretty too.
Uh-huh.
And then the chives. I'll just sprinkle
Very
some
nice.
Of the chives.
Good. Well, it makes a nice big bowl too. Nice big bowl.
God, yeah.
Very,
that'll
very nice.
Serve.
Yeah, a lot of people.
A lot of people.
And that's going to be a different because it's loaded with all the stuff that when you get baked potato, like a loaded baked potato at a restaurant, that's the stuff, the sour cream and the bacon, and that's all. So that taste is going to be good. You want to do something a little bit different than the traditional. I try not to make a lot of different dishes each year because they can drive you crazy because you're thinking, what if it doesn't turn out? You know, but what if it does? But it's still the same thing, you're just concerned. So don't do a bunch of them, just do a few or one or two. Okay, I'm gonna continue because I'm gonna make a sauce for this. It's gonna go on top. And we're gonna put this in the oven. We have some bread cubes. We're gonna put a can of soup with some broth, mix some sour cream in it, pour it on top, and then the breadcrumbs on top. Put that in the oven also. We'll be back in just a minute with a whole lot more of our Christmas dinner here at home.
Do you love watching At Home with Arlene Williams? Then be sure to check out our new YouTube channel. It's filled with classic episodes from over 20 years of At Home, and more videos are added each day. And don't forget to click the subscribe button so you'll never miss another episode of At Home.
Well, we've got a whole lot. The ham's in the oven. We've got a chicken cordon bleu casserole in the oven. A loaded potato salad's in the cooler. Paul's got the veggies done. Now we're finishing the rest of the dishes for our Christmas dinner. Paul, you're gonna make a dip now for his vegetables for an appetizer. People can nibble on that while you're still doing the finishing touches of dinner. So he's gonna work on that, and we'll talk about that later. You can go ahead and start, honey. Laura's gonna make some green beans, which is our vegetable, and she's also gonna make a pasta with a mushroom cream sauce. That's gonna be good. And if you wanna go ahead and get started, that will be good. I am making something I've made, and you're probably thinking, why are you making it again? Because everybody keeps asking me, could you make it one more time? This is that pineapple stuffing that anytime you have a ham, it goes so well with it. And my family, when we have get-togethers, if there's a ham and I don't bring this, they're upset. So I make it all the time. It's just bread. You get any kind of bread and you just cube it. You make a small cubes and tear it up. And it's about 15 or so slices of bread. And then you're gonna have a buttered casserole dish. What are you doing over there?
I'm just sauteing some onions and butter first, okay. And a little bit of garlic.
Okay.
And then I'm gonna add mushrooms.
Okay.
Now mushrooms give off a lot of water.
Moisture, yeah, they do.
A lot of water, so that has to cook down a little bit.
Okay. Now I've just added a can of the chunks of pineapple drained. You wanna take the water off that. And then a cup of sugar that goes in. All right. And I'm gonna do 2 eggs. How you doing, honey? Are you okay?
I'm okay.
You're okay.
Pineapple.
Pineapple, sugar. Yeah.
Pineapple.
And you could use the tidbits or crushed, whichever you want. But you just drain them, whatever you're gonna use. Make sure you drain them. And I have 2 eggs. This is gonna be the binding agent. And you don't wanna beat the tar out of them, but you wanna mix them up so that the yolk and the white are combined. And you're just gonna put that over the top of the bread and the sugar. Then I have make sure I have a half a cup of butter melted. And you just pour that over the top. And then you just mix it. And you have your 13x9 dish well buttered, because that's gonna add to the flavor of everything. It's gonna be good. Let me give you these, Laura. You can just pop them in that bus tub right there, which will be good. And then I'm just going to mix. Boy, something smells good. Anytime you cook garlic and butter and onion together, I mean, what else do you need, right? Yummy. Now those we're using the button mushrooms, but you could use portobellos, shiitakes, any kind you want. You can combine different flavors of different kinds. But we're just using the plain button mushroom, as they call it. Nice and big ones. We thank the Jordans because, boy, they really give us wonderful produce.
Beautiful produce.
And I hope that you're, you know, for the most part, all the baking's done, the shopping's done, the decorating, and now you can just enjoy the day with your family. And you know what? There's peace on earth, goodwill to men. Let's try to really key in on that during this season particularly. And let's determine that this next year we're going to pray for peace, particularly the peace of Israel and the peace of the whole wide world. because we know the Prince of Peace, who is Jesus, that's who we're celebrating during these special times. So that makes all this worthwhile. And don't be hard on yourself if you can't do it all. Ask for help or just don't do it. This will be a different kind of a season for you, different holidays. I used to struggle with that because I used to make, we always were entertaining every night of the week where somebody was at our house and we were cooking. And you know, after a while, you just can't do it anymore. And I thought, what's Christmas gonna be like? I can't do it. And I thought, still Christmas, still the Lord's birthday. We're still observing that. And you know what? That's the most important thing. Not how many presents are under the tree or how many trees you put up or whatever. That's not important.
No, I think it's keeping focused.
Absolutely.
Yeah, keeping focused.
How are we doing, honey?
Good.
Okay, tell me what you did here.
Okay. I had the
Go ahead.
I had the parsley and the chives and okay. the walnuts, and I put them in there. I ground them up.
Okay.
To be
real fine. Huh?
Real fine.
Okay.
Then I took them out and I mixed that with the blue cheese.
Ooh. And like then, about a half a cup maybe or so?
Yes.
Okay.
And then I put the cream cheese in there and made it smooth. And after I got smooth, then I put the
back in there.
Oh,
good.
Get that.
That's gonna be an awesome dip with those veggies. You can see he's got three beautiful kinds of vegetables there. And that's gonna be great for people to enjoy while they're waiting for the dinner to start to be served.
This is coming out nice.
Yeah. Oh, they're nice and dry, huh?
Yeah.
That's good, okay. What else goes in with that?
Well, when this is done, you use the heavy cream, which makes it so nice and rich.
Hey, we're splurging, Christmas.
Yeah, and salt and pepper to taste.
Okay.
But when you put the cream in, you gotta watch it a little bit because you
want it to curdle.
Yeah, and you wanna thicken it.
Right.
And it'll thicken up. And I made my pasta ahead of time. I did that right here, the farfalle.
So you already,
Yeah, that's already done.
Good. So that's one of those things you can do ahead of time and not have to worry the last minute.
I have green beans over here.
Okay, what are we doing with those?
Very simple, and again, like you said, Arlene, this time of season, we need to not have so much stress. So these recipes are great. Just fresh green beans, we cut them up a half inch.
Okay.
And onion soup mix.
Oh, okay.
Okay, just
dry?
Dry.
Wow.
And put in water. The water's gonna cook it a little bit.
Okay.
You mix it. When it's done, you have to cook that up a little bit. You'll see that about 10-15 minutes
a
the beans.
Sauce, huh?
Yeah, but the beans too need to cook because they're raw.
That's gonna add a lot of flavor to those beans. Oh my.
Flavor. That's
awesome.
Yeah, and that was a good half cup of the dry, dry mix. The ones you buy in a box, in a packet.
Lori, I'd like to have that cherry. I want to show the folks we made the cherry delight.
So the green beans, and then once you cover it, let it sit for a little bit, maybe 10 minutes. Beans are nice and tender.
Okay.
Then what you do is you top it off with nothing's better than fresh butter.
You got that right.
Fresh butter, some toasted almonds. I just toasted in this little skillet, little butter, and just heated these up. And then Parmesan.
What a wonderful combination.
And that's it.
A quick and easy last minute thing you can do quickly.
Very easy.
I also want to show you that this is called Cherry Delight. This is no cooking. How festive is that? You take two packages of cherry Jell-O. These recipes will all be included when you get your copy of this month's recipes. And there's some pineapple in here. There's maraschino cherries, of course. There's Cool Whip. They're all running together now. There's Cool Whip. And there's one other thing that I totally forget. Miniature marshmallows, I think I said that. But you know what, you'll get it, and all you do is mix it all together. And then, I'm sorry, mandarin oranges go in there too, drained. And then it just has to chill for 8 hours. So this is when you can do the date ahead, so you don't have to worry about, I have to get that ready today. You do it, you garnish it, beautiful cherries, stick it in the fridge, and you're ready to roll. Well, I think we're ready to roll, and there's a whole lot more to come. So you don't want to miss a bit of it, but you also need these recipes because you might want to try them out on your family. So here's how you can get today's recipes, the whole month's worth of recipes, cookies and everything else we've done all month long, and it's an easy way to get them. Here's how.
Just go to ctvn.org/at home to get all the recipes from today's show for free. That's right, No subscriptions. They're available online at no cost, and more are being added each day. So join us at ctvn.org/at home to get today's recipes now.
Well, this is our Christmas dinner table. We've got Laurie's joined us, and Laura's here, and Paul, and all of you, our friends and our family. We're so glad you could be with us. Let's see what we have in store for this Christmas dinner. It's our beautiful ham, my chili ham, and it tastes as good as it looks. You're just gonna love it. You have to try it. You'll love it. Here's our green beans. Oh, they're so wonderful. They've got a little bit of onion flavor to that and some almonds on top. Excellent. Down there is the Paul. That's your dip and your spread you made down there. That's to keep people happy until you get the dinner going. Next to it is a pineapple stuffing that's a must every time you have a ham. Then there's our mushroom, creamy mushroom over pasta. That's an excellent dish. Next to that is our chicken cordon bleu. It's got all the elements of a cordon bleu chicken dinner. And then back here's our loaded potato salad. Excellent. You're gonna love that. And as always, you know, every year we have a happy birthday, Jesus, because that keeps everybody at the table focused on what this is all about. Even your little ones need to see that and be reminded. Even sing happy birthday to Jesus. That would be great. And then here we have our cherry delight. We didn't get to show you how we make it, but that recipe is included. Very easy to do. Here's all the cookies we've been making for the last couple of weeks. We've got a punch there. I don't know what else we need, except we wish you could be with us here for our Christmas dinner. You know, it's a joy to come and serve you this way. And we trust and pray that you'll keep Christ in the center. Thank you, family. Thank you, friends. Thank you, family. Be sure to join us the next time, because it wouldn't be the same without you.
Food provided by Jordan Banana Company, wholesalers of fresh fruit and vegetables in Travosburg, Pennsylvania.
Don't forget to click the subscribe button so you'll never miss another episode of At Home.
Cornerstone Television wishes to thank all our faithful viewers whose consistent prayers and financial support have made this program possible.